Go to the Tools panel in Affinity Photo and select the Arrow tool. Then set a color, a stroke, stroke width, etc., and apply it. Now this one's filled with a gradient because that was obviously the fill over there, but you can make set to any color. So if you decide, you know, just a standard color, green, blue, etc., change it that way. However, the Arrow has probably got the most options available. You can modify it in numerous ways. So thickness, just change that. You can say there, thick or thin. So you can create a variety of different shapes that are not really particularly arrow-like. You can also change the ends as well very quickly. Though there's not a vast selection, it's a reasonable selection, however. So circle, you can also, if you decide, you know what, I don't want at all. So just go for none, and you've got just a very basic arrow at that point. Also, you can change there, just gonna go with length, so you can just squeeze that way or that. Also, you've got inner offset and so on and so on. Now, if you, of course, if I bring back that one again, and you'll notice what happens, you end up with these as well, these options, and you can vary those as well. Change that and so on. So create a variety of different arrow designs. Really useful, however, if you've decided you create one that you really like, always go up here, this little gear or presets, and you can go to the right side menu and you can create a preset. And I'm just going to go arrow, some name there, so make it unique and create. And it's added quickly to this list. And I've got a variety of different arrows, some that you've got with Affinity, some that I've created myself. And you can select them. However, unfortunately, you have to keep going back to the presets. It doesn't stick, so you have to just select it that way. Now, you can fill it with different things. You can also, if you go to the gradient tool, you can just turn around and say, I want bitmap. So you can select a bitmap, so an image, bring an image into your design as well, if you want to do that. Or if you want to color it in other ways, you can also use various other shapes. So you decide, you know what, I want the ellipse tool, say, go up here to the top right, and then go for insert, and then you can simply add the designs that way and change the color, of course, to make it a bit more exciting than that. So just do that and you can create a variety of, and they're all parts of that arrow, so you can move them around with the arrow, rotate, etc. Also, what you can do, you use pattern layers and many more things, maybe apply brush strokes, etc., to create a more unusual design as well. You can also apply effects. So here, you've got layer there, just go down to effects and click there. And then maybe go to, say, like 3D and add a quick 3D to give a nice 3D design, or maybe an outer shadow, etc. And you can still continue to work with that design. And it's still live. You can see still, as long as it's got arrow there. That's the key thing. Arrow, you can still go over here and change the indent size, change the length over here, etc. And of course, even the names change. You've got chevron length there, so you can vary that as well to create, again, a vast number of different designs. And of course, I guess if I go there diamond, it will suddenly change. Oh, diamonds lost that feature. But you can see a variety of different designs that way. Squared tail and so on. However, what else can you do with it? Well, you can convert it into curves. So if you don't want it anymore, you don't want to do any more work with the arrow, you don't want to manipulate it, you think this arrow is great, convert to curves. Once you've done that, you can go over here to the node tool and you can see all the different nodes that make this. And you can then still think, you know what, I want to change that. So decide to select that, and maybe make that arrow slightly different. Don't have to, but you can tweak it to create even more unique arrow designs if you want to do that. Point it out that way. So it's not just fixed forever with the arrow designs you've got available. You can do even more. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.